from your computer or mobile phones through which you are ordering that document. By the way, which all the documents or whatever that you are bought, it has been come to your place. So this is the online market. So here there is no place. That is why in the economics they are insisting about that it is an activity of a potential buyers and potential sellers are brought a close contact for the purchase and sale of a commodity. Okay, that is the market meaning. Okay, while explaining the market meaning, that you have to write this concept only in that economics. While you are writing in a marketing means marketing, marketing subject, you just write that it is a place. It is the place where buyers and sellers will meet each other for the exchange of goods and services. Okay. It is what I told. It is a market. Next, what are the different classification of markets? What is the classification of markets? It has been classified into area by the way of a area. That area is nothing but is called a geographical area. According to the geographical area, it has been classified into different markets like local market, family market, local market, family market, regional market, that market which is available within your region, national market, which is the market which have been done within our country, within our boundaries, that we can call it called a national market. And when you are going for an international level, you are going to do a market in an international level, then we can call it a international market. Okay, so according to the geographical area, the market has been classified. Next, according to the time, it has been classified like a very short market, long market, very long market. How we can classify very short market? Those products which have been dealt by the producer or seller, which is having a perishable nature, like a flowers, fish, these kind of markets are called a very short market. The products can be available for 1 or 2 days or 3 days, means that kind of market is called short market. Long market, which is available for, they are using, they are dealing with the durable products. That is a long and very long market. Okay, so according to the time of duration for which you can able to do the market, that kind of market is called a time. According to the time, that market has been classified. And then according to the commodity, that is a product exchange, bullion market, capital market, stock market. So these are all the, because of the commodity, according to the commodity that we are going to exchange in that market. Next, nature of transactions, spot market, forward market, and future market. So I don't want to go in the inside because of that these kind of markets you already know very well. Okay, next, volume of business, wholesale market and retail market. Those who are dealing in a wholesale basis, what is the difference between wholesale and retail? Do you know? Wholesale market.
Wholesale means wholesale market means we are going to sell it in a bulk orders and all we'll be giving. And
retail means
we'll be giving
small quantities
according to the small quantity to the customers.
Consumer for the consumption. Okay, good. So the wholesale market is a market, they are dealing the products in a bulk basis. They are not at all at any cost, they cannot deal with the consumers directly. They will deal only the retailers or brokers or anyone who is not at all, that wholesale markets are not at all directly concerned with the, connected with the consumers. The retail market, retailers are the persons who is directly have the contact with the consumers because of they are selling in a small quantities, small or lesser quantities to the the consumers. Okay. Next one is importance: primary market, secondary market, and tertiary market. And then regulation: regulated market, unregulated market. Regulated market means there are some regulations which have been formed. Accordingly, the market has been undertaken. That kind of market is called a regulated market. And there is no regulations has been formed means that is called unregulated market. In the economic side, perfect and imperfect. These are the things that we are going to see in a depth manner. Okay. Classification of market structure. Classification of market
regulation.
Structure. Yes, tell me.
Regulation, sir. Can you explain?
Regulation. Regulated market. Regulated markets are the market. There are some rules and regulations which have been framed in that market. That market. So that kind of market is called a regulated market. Unregulated market. For example, the street vendors are there. Street vendors. They are doing the market. Everywhere they are doing the market. Once if you are going for an online marketing, they have certain rules and regulations. Accordingly, only you have to do it. But if you are, if the vendors or sellers who is in the streets, they don't have any kind of regulations, rules and regulations. So that kind of market is called unregulated market. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
And then market structure, classification of market structure. This is very, very important. Okay. In the different classification of market structure, first one is called perfect competition. Perfect competition. Second one is imperfect competition. What is perfect competition? Perfect competition is a market structure. By the way, there is an absence of rivalry among the individual firms. How it is happens? There will be no rivalry among the individual firms. If you have a don't have a so too much of rivalry of an individual firm. How it is happens? Where it has happens? If the market structure is having a large number of buyers and sellers and with the homogeneous products. If you are doing a homogeneous products in the market, if you are doing a homogeneous products, you don't have that kind of rivalries. Okay, that kind of.
Sir, what is rivalry?
Rivalry means competitors. Competitors.
Okay. Sir.
Competitors. Okay. The competitors. The competitors. They are not having in that when you are dealing with the homogeneous products. Homogeneous product. Homogeneous means same type of products. Same type of products. For example, a good example for this perfect competition is agriculture market. Agricultural market. For example, in that when you are selling the rice for 50 rupees means that 50 rupees is sold for all the shops. For example. So here there is no rivalry. Wherever it is available, you are going to buy. Not you are going to buy in a particular place and then for the purchase of that particular product. Okay. That kind of liability or competition is not too much in this, that kind of perfect market. Okay, va? Okay. So here, what are the main features which have been in the perfect competition? What are the main features in the perfect competition? Perfect market. Just I will explain all the things. After that, I will go for the in-depth of the perfect competition. And then you can go for the imperfect competition. Imperfect competitions, we have a classification of, it's around five things. One is called a monopoly market. Monopoly market, what is that? Market which is having one seller and large number of buyers. Large number of buyers. In our nation, in our country, in all the worlds, they are restricting the monopoly. Monopoly. If the monopoly is there, they can fix any price. Accordingly, we have to purchase it. We have to purchase the commodity. So that is why most of the nations, all the nations are restricting that kind of monopoly act. Monopoly act. That will be act is that monopoly and restrictive practice act. Monopolies Restrictive Practice Act, that we can you know very well, MRTP Act. MRTP Act, that is the Monopolies Restrictive Trade Practice Act. Okay, so accordingly they are restricting the single seller. Okay, next one is called monopolistic. In this market, the market within which a firm can enter freely, each producing in their own brand and version of a differentiated product. Differentiated product in the monopolistic market. And oligopoly, those markets which having a few firms are entering into the market for doing the business. That is called the oligopoly. Duopoly means there is a two firms compete with each other. That is called duopoly. Monopsony, it is a market only one buyer. And a few sellers. So we will see in a depth manner. So these are the various markets which have been comes under imperfect market that we will see in depth. Okay. First we will go to the perfect market. What is perfect market? In this perfect market structure, I already told that it's a market structure by a complete absence of rivalry among the individual firms. There is no that such kind of a rivalry. For example, you are going to do a agricultural business, means agriculture, means there is no rivalry. Okay. Everyone is going to do a agriculture, same kind of products that they are going to produce, they are going for the sale. So there is no such kind of a rivalry or competition which will exist in the perfect market. Okay, here in this perfect market, we have a basically two features. We have given eight features, two things. That is called, one is pure competition, another one is perfect market. These are the two conditions. The pure competition among the producers. And second thing is called perfect market for the commodity. What is that? Which will come in the pure competition? In this pure competition, there is a large number of buyers and sellers. That is the first and foremost characteristics of perfect market. What is that? Large number of buyers and sellers. Here in this perfect market, you have a large number of buyers and sellers. Buyers as well as large, sellers also large. And second important thing is called homogeneous product. What is that? Homogeneous means are in the same nature. Those products that they are dealt by the sellers or producers are of a same nature. It is available in the market. And then there will be a free entry and exit. That is not available here. So third important point in the pure competition is free entry and exit of firm. You are free to enter. There is no restriction for doing that kind of perfect in the perfect competition market. And if you are not at all interested in doing that business, you just go, went away. Okay, that free entry and exit is available in that perfect market. Okay, next one is, I already told that perfect market. What is perfect market? Market relates with perfect knowledge about the market, that the seller as well as buyers, they are having very much good knowledge about the market. That is the third or fourth point. Next one is called, there is a perfect knowledge, I already told that, perfect mobility of factors of production. The factors of production can be easily mobile. Mobile in the sense, it can be transferred from one area to another area. The factors that labor and other factors like capital can be easily moved from one area to another area. That is a perfect mobility of factors of production which is available in the perfect market. And then ruling price which have been fixed in the perfect market, that will be stable for most of the times. For example, what is happening here in this in the Delhi also, the onion price is 80 rupees or 100 rupees. That is the same price which is available in Tamil Nadu also. Okay, that is a ruling prices. Okay, for a tomato, it's only 15 rupees or 20 rupees. And that is the same price which is available in all the areas. Okay, that is the point. There is a ruling prices. And then, and here it is an absence of transportation cost. Absence of a transportation costs in the perfect market. Actually, they have to do an absence of transport cost. What is the production cost? Accordingly, only they want to sell it. But they are changing their cost. But in the perfect market, the absence of transport cost. And then seventh one is called the profit maximization. Profit maximization, and then freedom in decision making. If they are in the perfect market, they are very much free and they can take a decision on their own. Okay, so these are the main important features of perfect market. Okay, are you clear? Are you clear about this perfect market?
So can you give another example for perfect market?
Actually, that agricultural products, agricultural firms, agriculture related firms. Agriculture related firms who are dealing the agricultural products are the perfect example of
okay.
And then next we will move to the imperfect market. Imperfect market, in that imperfect market, the first and foremost is called a monopoly market. Monopoly. What is monopoly? I already told that monopoly is a structure in which there is a single firm producing all the output. Single firm producing the all output. Here in this PPT, what I told, mono means single. Poly means seller. There's a single seller. Single seller. The monopoly is a market structure. Only one sells the goods and services, and there is a many buyers. The firm produces the entire supply of the particular goods or service that have no close substitutes. When you are asking the example for this, water supply, railways, before that postage. These are the examples of a monopoly. Okay, here also the government is giving the water supply. They are not giving to the, now it has been changed to even to privatization. Private people, they are charging 1 liter bottle for 20 rupees or 25 rupees. The distilleries water, distilleries and Aquafina, like that. So, but before that, only the water supply has been done by the government sectors, by public sectors. So that the time, that is a monopoly. It's a monopoly.
Electricity,
railways, airways, military arms and ammunition production. So these are some of the monopoly sectors which is available in our country. Okay. Yeah, and then what are the features? What are the characteristics? Characteristics of monopoly. First, I already told that single seller is a single seller. And second one is there is no close substitute. There is no close substitute for your commodity produced by the monopolist. So once if you are a no close substitute means what do? While you are doing the market, while you are in the market, if you are a monopoly, what do you do while fixing the price? You can fix a high price or not?
Yeah.
You fix the high price or not? That is my question.
High price.
Definitely you can fix a high price. Definitely you fix a high price because you are a monopoly. You thought that I am the only seller, that whatever I am fixing for that you have to buy. That attitude will come to your mind or not?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Definitely, yes. So you should, you can fix the high prices. So who is the sufferer? The buyers. The buyers are all the sufferers in the side. So then that is why we can say that monopoly markets are called a price maker. That we can call it as called a price maker. Price maker. We can call it as a price maker. And third one is called a, there is a restriction for the entry and exit of the firm. If in the monopoly market, you are a single seller. If anybody who is interested to come forward to do the business of the same nature, whether you can easily accept that new firm? No, definitely you cannot easily accept because of high amount of restrictions or a high amount of blocks has been formed to restrict the entry. As well as if you are only one seller who is dealing that product, you cannot exit easily from that market. So there is a restriction in both the area, both the ways, like both the entry as well as the exit of the market. Okay, next one is called a perfect knowledge. The monopolist is assumed to be having a perfect knowledge about the market conditions. Hence, the uncertainty about the developments of markets in the ruled out. Okay, here what is that? In that features, they are giving that it is a perfect knowledge. It is assumed monopoly is not there, not too much in that our country or all over the world. So the monopoly is assumed to be have a perfect knowledge about the market condition. Okay, so these are the various features of a monopoly. And here, another important while fixing the price is discriminating prices are the main important feature of a monopoly market. What is discriminating prices? Do you know? In that monopoly market, you are selling the product for the different prices for the different consumers. Why you are giving like that? Why you are giving?
To earn more, because they are the only seller.
Yes, you are the only person. You can whatever decision you thought, you can give it. For example, someone who stole the electricity. Yes, in that electricity, the prices of electricity is common for all.
Yes, no, sir. It is a difference.
While you are using for 100 kilowatts for some prices, when you are using 500 kilowatts, they are having certain amount of fixing the price. Above 500 or 5500, they are giving a separate prices. So that kind of prices is called discriminating price. This kind of pricing is called a discriminating prices. And also, if you are the transport buses, these are some of the examples. Transport buses for the from the railways, and then some of the doctors who is treating the patients. For some people, they are giving charging higher amount of fees, and for some people, they are charging very less amount. So these are some of the examples of the monopoly for discriminating monopoly. Okay, are you clear about the monopoly?
Sir, I had one doubt. In one product in state is sold, say, at 55 rupees, but in another state, there's one product, it has been sold at as 55 rupees as an example in one state.
Okay,
but same thing they are selling at by raising 3 or 4 rupees in another state. So this can also be considered as a monopoly price, sir.
In that case, they are adding certain amount as an additional cost.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
By the way of charging as a transportation cost. So I think that should be added. That we cannot consider as a monopoly. These are considered a monopolistic.
Okay, sir.
These are the main concepts comes in the monopoly market. Next, we will move on to the difference between perfect market and the monopoly market. A perfect market is unrealistic in practical life, but slowly certain commodities are moving towards it. Monopoly market exists in real time. And the perfect market, only homogeneous products are sold, but on the other hand, the monopoly market deals with the different products. And a perfect competition, prices is determined by demand and supply of the market, and the, but the monopoly seller determines the price, and in the monopolist can control the market price. In the perfect market, there is no control. There is no control over the market price. Here, in this perfect market, there is no advertisement. While selling the agriculture products, we are not giving an advertisement. That's the perfect market. But in this monopoly, they are giving us some amount of additional cost of production. It has been reflected in the price. And then in this monopoly, they sell their products higher than the perfect competitors. And then according to the regulations of the government. Okay, so these are the some of the difference between the monopoly and the perfect market. Okay.
Excuse me, sir. So electricity example.
What is that? Tell me.
Sir, that electricity example, no?
Yes.
So it comes under which market, sir?
Monopoly, ma.
Monopoly. Okay, sir.
Monopolistic competition.
This means that the perfect market and monopoly market has only one seller.
No. In that perfect competition, we have a large number of buyers and sellers. That is the main feature I already explained. In that monopoly market, you are only one seller, large number of buyers. This is the difference.
Okay.
Next one is called a monopolistic market. Monopolistic. Here, monopolistic is market. Polistic competition. In this monopolistic competition, here the perfect competition, monopolies are the two extreme forms which will be included in the monopolistic competition.
Monopolistic competition.
Okay. That is a gap, which is a gap, the concept of monopolistic competition, which have been developed by Edward Chamberlain. Okay, here the both the elements like many sellers and many small buyers, which is comes in this monopolistic market. For I just explained the concept. Monopolistic market structure is that many firms selling close related unidentical commodities. This is the main important feature of a monopolistic competition. Once again, I can repeat it. What is that? The many firms selling closely related but unidentical commodities. Unidentical commodities. Here, in this perfect competition, these are homogeneous products. Here, in this monopolistic competition, the firm selling the close related, but unidentical. It's not identical. What is the example? Automobiles, textiles, televisions, all are soft drinks, detergents, soap, detergent soaps. Okay. In that market are called a monopolistic market. You can say that our country, we are dealing with the different varieties of products by the different firms, large number of sellers and large number of buyers is there with the different close related, but it is an unidentical commodities. Whether our Indian markets are monopolistic market or monopoly market, please tell me.
Monopolistic market.
It's a monopolistic market because many firms are selling closely related. For example, you take an example of television, even LG, Samsung, and different products are available. They are all of a same close related, but unidentical commodities. And then we can go for Hindustan, HLL. They are producing varieties of products, but unidentical products. Okay. In our nations, mostly it is a monopolistic competitions will exist. Okay. In this monopolistic competitions are the main important area that will be our market structure. Okay. While while going for an only perfect competition, that is also not possible. And then when you are going for a monopoly, that is also it is impossible, because they can cheat their consumers. That is why they are going for the monopolistic competition. Monopolistic competition by the way of providing a different varieties of products which are closely related but unidentical products. Unidentical products. So that kind of market is called a monopolistic competition or monopolistic market. Before going to the oligopoly, I just explained the features of a main features of a monopolistic competition. First one is, I already told that large number of buyers and sellers. Large number of buyers and sellers are available in the monopolistic competition. And then second one is called, main important thing is called product differentiation. Product differentiation. It is closely related. This unidentical products. Unidentical means it is called a product differentiation. And third one is called free entry and exit. Here it also what is come in the proper competition that will available here. Free entry and entry and exit of the firm. And then fourth one is very, very important in the monopolistic competition. That is imperfect knowledge. Imperfect knowledge. In that present situation, you know very well, we are buying a lot of products from the market. Whether you know that knowledge about particular products while you are buying the product, they are selling. They are giving in that advertisement. Whether they are giving the advertisements or having a same nature, no, definitely no. The advertisements are the cheating business. Advertisements are the cheating business. Only they are giving an information. So information, and also most of the cases that are of false information. So accordingly we are buying that product. Finally, we are all the cheaters. So most of the cases, most of the products, we are not at all perfect knowledge about the product as well as market.
Excuse me, sir. You were telling like there is large number of sellers and large number of buyers.
Yes.
So all these sellers are some or other way they are closely related.
Yes, definitely.
Is it a compulsory condition that they should be closely related?
Yes, definitely. If the sellers are closely related, means related in the sense, as a what I trying to say is, the firm who is selling. On what basis I am telling it is close related means the products that they are producing.
Okay, sir, I understood. It means Onida LG. This basis on the product they are selling or the company?
Yes.
Confused. Is it company or product, sir?
Product.
Products are closely related.
But it is unidentical.
Unidentical. Okay,
sir. Imperfect knowledge. For the market, both buyers as well as sellers do not have a perfect knowledge and complete knowledge about the market conditions. The buyer preferences are guided by advertising, and other selling activities are undertaken by the sellers. They don't have so much of knowledge about that market conditions. When the seller who is selling, while you are asking some question about some kind of technologies which are used in that particular product. For example, you are going to buy LG washing machine. When you are going to the seller, you just ask me why this kind of things are happening, why it comes. You just ask them whether he can able to answer. No, definitely. No, because even the seller is not in a position to know that perfect knowledge about the product as well as market. Okay, that is available in that is mainly come in this monopolistic market. And then selling cost. The firm under monopolistic competition incurs selling cars to increase the demand of its product. Okay, even advertising, window displaying, salesman salaries are to be included in that cost of a product. Okay, what someone has asked that, which is the one product is available in 55 rupees and some other state it is available in 60 rupees. Why? They will include some other extra cost. Okay, in that monopolistic market, that will happen. We cannot answer anyone. We cannot answer anyone because they are having their own rules and regulations. So accordingly, they can include that cost because of that any window displaying or advertising or salesman salaries or any extra cost that they can incur, that should be included in this selling cost. And then here, this monopolistic competition, we have a high transport cost. Okay, high transport cost. Even you know very well that is now it is a Diwali season. In Tamil Nadu, you know very well, if the Sivagasi is the producer, the highest producer of crackers. Here in the Sivagasi, we are buying a product for 1,000 rupees, for example. When I am buying a product of 1,000 rupees, that the same product, the same amount of same quantity of products which is available in the Delhi means for 5,000 rupees. Why? Same quantity of products just available.
The transport cost is added to the original cost.
Because of transport cost. Okay. So that is the reason. So it is in this monopolistic competition, they include high transportation cost. High transportation cost. The cost of transporting of a commodity from one place to another place is very high under this monopolistic competition. Okay. These are the main features of monopolistic competition. Okay, so you just explain this monopolistic competition in that way. Next one is oligopoly market. What is oligopoly? In this market, only few sellers of homogeneous nature who's dealing or differentiated products who's dealt by oligopoly market. In that oligopoly market, Only few sellers who is dealing the total market. Few sellers. We have a large number of buyers, but only few sellers who is doing that total control over the total market. That kind of market is called a oligopoly market. When only two peoples or two firms who is doing that who are controlling the market or doing the market, means that kind of market is called a duopoly. The sellers are only two sellers, we can call it a duopoly. Okay, only few sellers, we can call it as a oligopoly. Okay, in that oligopoly are of two types. One is pure oligopoly and second one is called differentiated oligopoly.
An example of the oligopoly.
Oh yes, I'll give. For example, you just think of oil suppliers, crude oil suppliers or petrol suppliers. Okay. In India, who is supplying the in a bulk way? They are purchasing from the Arab countries and after that they are distributed only by, nowadays it has been even the privatization takes place, lot of newcomers are even Reliance and other industries are dealing before that, I am telling about before 5 to 10 years back or 20 years back. Who is only Indian Oil. Indian Oil and then Hindustan. And like that, only two or three companies who is dealing all the oil supply to all over India. Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir. So for a product, only two or three companies are selling one type of product.
In a similar product. Okay. There are three companies or four companies, they are selling the three homogeneous products.
So about
all over India of a full of a large number of buyers, that kind of market is called a oligopoly market. And even two or three companies who are selling a differentiated products, that we can call is called a differentiated oligopoly. It's called a differentiated oligopoly. For example, here, that is also, nowadays I cannot give a perfect example. Why? Because of privatization, globalization, lot of new companies have introduced. So here there is an oligopoly market is also somewhat restricted. So in I just give an example only before 15 years or 20 years only. For example, the car companies, automobile companies, computer companies, computer software companies. So these are all some of the companies who is dealing with the differentiated products, which is having a few sellers. This comes under oligopoly market. Okay. And then different
excuse me, sir. So in every case, the number of buyers is same, no?
Number of buyers are large in nature.
In every form of market or competition.
Yes, yes. That here in this two oligopolies are there. One is pure oligopoly. Pure oligopoly, it occurs if you are the few sellers who is dealing a homogeneous products. Okay. Homogeneous of similar products means that kind of oligopoly is called a pure oligopoly. If the few sellers or few firms which is dealing in differentiated products, that we can call as a differentiated oligopoly. Okay. So these are the two important types of oligopoly. Okay. Next, features of oligopoly. What is features of oligopoly? Features of oligopoly, I already explained that there is a few sellers. There is a few sellers. And then homogeneous products are differentiated products. There is a lack of uniformity in the products. Okay. For example, even the oil companies, not only they are selling petrol, they are selling kerosene and other products related, petroleum products, which is sold by gasoline, like that. So other different uniform, there is lack of uniformity in that particular homogeneous product. Okay. Next, advertisement cost is included. No monopoly competition. The firm struggle constantly, and there is an interdependency, and the price. And another important characteristics called price rigidity, price rigid, and then price leadership. Whatever the price which have been fixed by that that three firms, that will be common for all the buyers, and that is the price leadership. And another company, whether the new company is going to enter in the market, they will restrict it. Same like a monopoly. Now only after the globalization was takes place only, now the privatization, a lot of new companies are come forward to do the business in the, even in the petroleum areas. Before that, there is no such kind of things have been incurred or had in the oligopoly market. And another important thing which is comes in the oligopoly market is,
excuse me, sir, you were showing some more types of oligopoly, huh?
What?
Some more types of oligopoly, okay, other than pure and differentiated. Something like open and closed.
Listen. You just explain only two market, that itself enough. These are the main two things. These
pure
are
pure and differentiated.
Other types are very sub type. No need to explain those things. Only you just explain two important that is pure oligopoly. Differentiated oligopoly.
Okay, sir. Sir, audio is not audible.
In that oligopoly market, there is a audio.
Now it's okay.
In that oligopoly market, there is a kinkri demand curve. This is a specialty of graph which will be come in this kinkri demand curve, which is applicable in the oligopoly market. That oligopoly market, kinkri demand curve. Why that kinkri demand curve will happens? You just see that kinkri demand curve. The curve is always just like a U shaped or like it is down or downtrends or a upward trends. It's a demand curve. It's a downward sloping. But there will be a kink. That is means there will be a increase. After that, there will be a cut. That is called K is there. K is here. That K is the point of kink. Why that kink was happened? Kink was happened. It is based on the assumption that the firms must match cuts but not price rises. It rationalizes the price rigidity is the oligopoly market because of the price rigidity. Because of the price rigidity, that kinkri demand curve come in the oligopoly market. It shows that even if cost changes, what is the reason of that cut was takes place means even the cost changes, the price charged by the commodity does not change. That is the main concept in the kinkri demand curve. Once again, I can repeat it. Even the cost of the production changes, the price charged by the commodity does not change. The price of the commodity does not change in this kinkri demand curve. That is why there will be a bend. There will be a bend in that curve. That kind of curve is called the kinkri demand curve. The kinkri demand curve is come in this oligopoly market only. While they want to explain this kinkri demand curve, you just explain the kinkri demand curve by the way of drawing this kind of graph as a kinkri demand curve. Because of this price discrimination. And another important concept in this oligopoly market is price discrimination. The price discrimination means that the producer charges different prices for different consumers for the same goods and services. This is comes under monopoly market. These things I already explained, price discrimination. From that only, our third unit will be over.
Which one, sir? Sir, kinkri demand curve is under oligopoly only, no?
Yes, it is comes under oligopoly market.
Comes under monopoly price discrimination?
Discrimination comes under monopoly market. Under this monopoly market, the price discriminating monopoly. I just already explained that discriminating monopoly is a situation where the monopoly market because of the differentiated price for the different products, different consumers. Okay, if you have any questions, please ask me.
Sir, what is monopsony?
Monopsony is the single buyer. You are the single buyer. For example, I will give an example that who is buying the gold? Who is buying the gold in the present situation? We are buying by in a private way by the way of a from other country. Before that, only one particular sector or particular government should buy the gold or crude oil from the sellers or producers, and then buy it. After that, they can distribute it. After that, they will distribute. Here, only one seller, only one buyer in this market. That is called a monopsony.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Sir, in textbook, there are so many graphs that are given. So, should we read those for examination point of view?
Tell me once again.
There are so many graphs that are being given in the textbook. So, for examination point of view, should we study those?
That is mainly meant for a relationship. for the relationship purpose only, they are giving the prices, graphs. Even you are explaining those graphs that I need to relation how the relationship was takes place. That is the main thing which is comes under this. Even monopolistic market, monopoly market, and even in that oligopoly market, how you are going to fix the price. For that only the graph. It is a very simple way. You are going to make a relationship. Relationship of the marginal cost and average cost. So like that, in the last class I just explained about that, how that marginal cost, it slopes downwards, slopes upwards, how it comes. That is the explanation which have been come in this relationship in this graph. You just read that kind of concept. That will be very easy. You no need to more stress on that particular graph areas. Okay. You know that concept very clearly. Accordingly, you just read that, all those things. That will be easy. Don't think that while watching the graph, why this kind of graphs is coming. Don't think that. You just read that concept, why that graph was drawn. Okay.
That will be easy.
Okay, sir.
Thank you.
Okay. Or if you have any other doubt, please ask me. Thank you for your contribution as well, sir. Patient listening at my classes.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. The next class we will go for the macroeconomics. This is only what are the things that we saw, that is called the microeconomics. First one is managerial economics, demand, supply, production analysis, and then finally in that market structure, definitely they will ask what are different types of market structure. Even in the market structures, monopolistic market, monopoly market, and oligopoly market are the expected questions in this market structure. Okay, that is why I already told that these are the very important things. And also,
Hello, sir.
Tell me.
Sir, king in the demand curve occurs because of the rival firm's behavior based on the price cut.
Even the cost of the production, even the cost of productions of the price, cost of production of the particular product has been increased or decreased. You cannot change the price very easily because a large number of buyers who are selling the product. The government in the present situation, every week the petrol prices are increasing, decreasing. Every day the petrol prices are increasing, decreasing because of the privatization. Private people are entered in the market. Before that, once in 6 months, or only once in 3 months, or only once in a year, only the petrol prices are increasing before 20 years back. Okay, sir. In that cases, the demand curve, the Kingery demand curve comes into the oligopoly market. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Sir, due to that price rigidity, that Kingery is coming.
Yes, because of price rigidity.
Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Sir, excuse me, sir. I lost the connection in between. Can you please tell me that graph once more? King demand curve.
There will be a kink. There will be a kink means it's called a cut. Why that cut happens in the King demand curve means that is because of the price rigidity. I already explained that concept. Because of the price rigidity, happens because of that. Even the cost prices or cost of productions have increased or decreased, but the price cannot differ because of the large number of buyers who is getting the products. Okay, that is the reason for which the price rigidity happens. Okay, that is the main reason for which the Kingery demand curve, the king cost happen in this oligopoly market.
Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.